there, friends. Welcome back to the channel where we make all things Kajabi simple, actionable, and fun. I'm Rebecca Austin, your Kajabi mentor and conversion coach, and today we're diving into a step-by-step tutorial that will unlock one of Kajabi's most powerful tools, and that is coupons. If you've ever wondered how to set up Kajabi coupons to boost sales, reward your audience, or create irresistible offers, this is the video for you. I'll be sharing my screen and walking you through exactly how to create, customize, and apply coupons in Kajabi so you'll have everything you need to get started today. And if you're ready to go beyond the basics and really take Kajabi game up a notch, be sure to check out my signature coaching program, Conversion Code. It's designed to help you get Kajabi confident and overcome the roadblocks keeping you from growing your online business. You'll find the link in the description below. Now let's jump in and start creating those coupons. Okay, so this is our test Kajabi account so that we can show everything that we need to without worrying about blurring out things. We want to make sure that we keep it super transparent for you. And to start creating coupons, you'll find the coupon settings under your sales tab. So we just simply click here to open up our sales, and then we click coupons. Now, before we create a coupon, you do have to have at least one offer created inside Kajabi that has some kind of pricing attached to it. So if you're first getting started and you haven't set up an offer yet, or if you haven't integrated your payment integrations where you actually have it where you can collect money, then it won't make any sense to create a coupon yet. So start there if you haven't already. Integrate your payments. Make sure that you have at least one offer set up. Offers you can do here under the offer. We have a separate tutorial where we go into specifically offer on setting everything up in Kajabi as well. So for coupons, when you click here on coupons, it'll bring you to this screen, and all you need to do is click on this black button here at the top, create new coupon. Now, this is where the magic is. This is where it gets really exciting, and this is where Kajabi has two different types of coupons that you can create depending on the needs and the types of coupons that you want to offer. There's different strategies and purposes behind each, so I'm going to go through this with you really fast so that you can understand which one you're creating when you're inside the program. So the single coupon code, essentially what that is, think of it as it's a single code, not single coupon, that you're only creating one coupon. You're creating a single code that you can give out that multiple people can use the same code. So that would be for using for things like promotions, like you're going to do an end of the year sale or a Black Friday sale, or your anniversary, or a launch discount kind of thing. That's where you're giving the same coupon code and you're promoting that same coupon code out where multiple people can use the same code. Bulk codes could be a single code, but we call it bulk codes because you're telling the system, I want to create this many codes that can only be used once. And each code is a unique code that can be sent to an individual person, and then that person can only use that code once. They can't share the code. You have different tracking and analytics from that perspective. So single coupon codes where we use the single coupon is for promotions, bulk coupons. This, a lot of times we use this for things like if you have an employer who is wanting to purchase for their employees and you want to have a bunch of different coupons where the employer purchases this many seats, for example, and then you're giving them the coupon codes that they can have their employees fulfill, and you don't have to worry about numbers, that you control the narrative. So that would be one example of bulk coupon codes. Sometimes we'll use bulk coupon codes for things like events, or if you're using a different payment system in order to collect money and then you want to send them into Kajabi using that single coupon. So I'm going to show you both single coupon codes being the most common, the most prolific. We use this the most often, so to speak. And so we're going to do that one first. At the end, I'll jump into bulk codes. It's pretty much the same process, but there's a few minor details that are different from the bulk perspective. So when we're creating a coupon code, starting with single coupon, first you have to name your coupon. So this is where what do we want the code to be that we're sending out for people to use? You tell Kajabi what you want that code to be. In bulk codes, you just tell the system how many, and then Kajabi automatically generates these codes. So you don't tell Kajabi what you want the code to be for bulk codes. The single code is where you tell what you want the code to be. A bonus tip on this one, we do want to keep it pretty simple, something that's easy for people to remember. Since you do want to then share this coupon code, you can be emailing it out, you can have it in your social media posts. So we want to make sure that it's real easy for people to apply that coupon when they go to checkout. And there are ways that you can work around that. I'll share that in the next video where we talk about auto applying a coupon code to make it easier and seamless. For now, I'm just going to walk you through the basics of setting it up. So what we're going to call this is a VIP 20. And then you would say what type of discount you want this to be. So you can either do percentage off or you can do a specific amount depending on what you want to do in this coupon. So for this scenario, I'm just going to say percent off and I'm going to give a 20% off coupon. And then there's duration. Now, duration comes into play, especially when you're doing subscriptions or multi-payments. It doesn't really apply as much if you're doing a single one-time payment, because anytime that you're doing a one-time payment, it's going to be a one-time coupon. But when we get into payments for or coupons for subscription payments or multi-pay, this is then where we tell the system, does it only count for the first payment? Or do we want it to be repeating or forever? So this is then where, depending on how you want that coupon to be applied, you would select the duration. Then we can add an expiration as well. So if this is an ongoing coupon that you want it to be open-ended forever, you could just leave this blank. However, a good rule of thumb, especially on certain strategies around coupons, is to put an expiration date. So this coupon is only good for a certain period of time. And that way it builds some of that urgency, scarcity and urgency that we talk about from a sales perspective. We get people to take advantage of this discount before it expires so that they're not missing out on this opportunity for this special rate. So this is then where you can put in that expiration date. So in this case, I'm going to then continue. Now your coupon is created, but it's not done. So at this point, we can't edit. Once you have created create and you're like, oh shoot, it should have been 50% off instead of 20% off, you really can't go in and edit these settings. You would just simply need to delete the coupon and start over if you need to make any changes to what you've already created. So that's just a side caveat as far as what Kajabi is doing right now. That may change in the future. We never know. Kajabi's always making adjustments. But at the time of recording this video, you would need to delete the coupon and then start over if you're wanting to make any edits. But we're not done because now the coupon's created, but it's not attached to anything in your system. So in order to make sure that this is actually then a coupon code, we have to tell the system what offer or offers do we want this coupon code to be applied for. So this is where the next step on this screen is very important. If you miss this step, you'll have a coupon code, but it doesn't go anywhere. It's just a dead code. So what we want to do is we want to click on add offer, and then we're going to select the offer that we want to apply this coupon code to. So I can apply it to our test offer that we created in our tutorial on creating offers. And then if I want to, I can apply this to multiple offers. So if you want to have it just be a 20% off coupon for everything in your store, you simply have to then take a moment and add all of your offers that you want this coupon code to be applicable for. So we can add another offer. So maybe we're going to have this applicable as well to this Fostering Healthy Habits offer that we have available here. So once you've added all of the offers that you want that coupon code to now be available for, then you simply click done. Now here's a little side tip for you before I exit this screen. One of the things that you'll notice is as soon as I add an offer, there is now a discount link. if you copy this discount link, and if I were to go into a new browser and I'm going to paste this discount link into a new browser, one of the things that you'll notice is that the discount link specifically automatically applies the coupon without having to enter the coupon code. So if I'm back here in the coupon and I click done, and then we go into our offer and we look at our checkout and we preview the checkout, you'll notice now on this offer that it has a coupon form field here at the top. So we have the ability now where I could enter VIP20 and apply, and it will apply that coupon code, but the person does have to click or enter VIP20 and then apply. So we have two different ways now at this point that someone can get access to this coupon code. One is through the direct link. The other is by entering the coupon code. In our next video, like I said, I'm going to go deeper into ways that you can strategize making it easier for your audience to have this coupon code applied at checkout. So we'll talk about that in the next video. But I just wanted to plant the seeds here so that you can also know that there's two ways then that you can share this coupon with your audience. And that is through the coupon code where you share the code itself or through the discount link. That is pretty much it on single coupons. It's pretty straightforward. It's very simple. We simply go in and edit what our code is, what we want our amount or percentage to be, and then add our offers and then click done. You want to add your expiration date, of course, if you wanted to have it expire, and that's it. So that is how to set up single coupon codes. Now, if we want to do bulk coupon codes where we have multiple codes that are created, if I click on bulk codes, one of the things that you'll notice is that it changes just a little bit. So on single coupon codes, it says coupon code, and we want to enter what the code is. Under bulk codes, it says coupon name. So the coupon name is how do you want to organize your coupon? So when you're looking at your coupon list, do you know what that is? So for example, as a good rule of thumb, if I'm using this, for example, I want to have an employer who is buying for their employees. Generally, what I will do is I will put the employer name in this coupon box so that it makes it easier for me when I'm looking at all my coupons. It's like, oh yeah, this one is for that client. This one's for that client. This one's for that client. It's much easier from an organization perspective. So think about what makes sense to have the name for this coupon that works for you on the back end from an organization perspective, especially thinking long-term. So even if it's just the employer name, maybe you want to include the employer name and the year or the month and the year, depending on how you have your program set up. So in this case, I'm just going to make this Strive for Savvy, which is our company, just as an example. It might help if I spell it right. And then we'll say 2024. Then again, the rest of it is pretty much straightforward. Percentage off or amount off. So maybe I want to do 100% off because this is specifically for the employer. The employer is already paying. We're using these codes then for the employees to just get their access and their onboarding and all of those kind of things. So I will do 100% off here since I'm invoicing the employer separately, which you can do invoicing through Kajabi now too as well. Just a little caveat, side note on that. Then comes the important part, how many coupon codes do we want to create? Meaning how many codes do we want to send to this particular employer, which is real easy. It's how many that they paid for, or depending on the strategy and how you're using this, how many do you want to have available? So another use for this that some of our clients have done is they're doing a special VIP beta launch, and they want to use coupons as a way of controlling their numbers of how many people come in on the beta. And so what they do is then they say, okay, I want 50 people in on my beta. So they'll do 50 coupons on the amount of coupons. And then the discount might be whatever you are promising for your beta group. So it's like, okay, well, normally it's this much, but because you're coming in on our early access VIP beta group, you're getting it for 30% off, 40% off, however you want to do your coupon. And then we are the only available to the first 50 people who enroll. Then you could use bulk coupons for that. So then you would do your percentage off or your amount off. You would then set your amount of coupons. So I'm just going to say for now that it's an employer and they're purchasing 10, and then we're going to click continue. Now, then what happens is the system is automatically generating 10 codes. So you'll notice then if I click on show available codes, these are the 10 codes that Kajabi has generated. And each one of these codes can only be used once. So what we do then is we can export all the codes. There's an option here to export the codes. You'll get a CSV file, which then you can send to the employer and they can keep track on whatever makes sense for them. You can then pull a report to see, all right, how many are available? How many have been redeemed? So you can say, here's the available ones, and then here's the redeemed codes. So then you can stay in touch with the employer when you're getting closer to launch date, for example. Hey, we're getting ready to launch. I'm noticing that these are the two coupon codes that have not been redeemed yet. You may want to touch base with your employees to make sure that they redeem those coupons before the deadline, those kind of things. So you can see where the sky's the limit with these coupon codes. There's so much that we can do with them. They're incredibly powerful. But again, on this one, just like before, but we're not done yet. We need to add the offers that we want them to be attached to. So this is then, once again, we would add our offer or offers. And then once everything is taken care of, we click done. And then you'll be able to see on your main dashboard, what are the coupon codes that we have available that we've created? There's all, but then we can also break it down into just looking at our bulk codes and just looking at our single codes. Now, this is super helpful over time for some of you who have been in the industry for a while and you're doing this on a regular basis and you're selling to a lot of employers, for example. You want to be able to sort these or to be able to make it easier to find the active ones or the inactive ones and that kind of thing. So that is, from the back end, a real easy way then where we can then at least subcategorize them a little bit between single codes and bulk codes. And there you have it. Now you know exactly how to create and use Kajabi coupons, and you can use them to drive sales and reward your audience. Now, if you're ready to take it a step further, don't forget to check out my conversion code program. Whether you're just getting started or looking to level up, this program is designed to help you navigate Kajabi with confidence and achieve real results in your business. The link's in the description below. I'd love to see you inside. Oh, and before you go, make sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications, because in the next video, as I said, we'll be showing you how to make Kajabi coupons even more powerful by automatically applying discounts at checkout. Trust me, you don't want to miss this one. And until then, remember, the key to success is taking action and staying consistent. Keep learning, keep growing. Bye for now.